he would love to play basketball against you, and he told me to tell you that when you play, he's gonna send your shit to the moon. He's gonna block you. But I told him, I showed him some videos where you cross over some superstars and you hit your shots and you do backflips.
Hey man, I can do it all, man. It ain't nothing I can't do, man. I take up your offer though. But we gonna get this fight out the way February 20th, then I'll come see you.
Virgil's fighting Maurice Hooker. What do you guys think?
Good fight for the sport. Tough fight, but hopefully Maurice pull it out. I'm pulling for Maurice.
Josh Taylor.
How can you ask me that in this February?
Josh Taylor, Jose Ramirez.
Josh. I don't think Ramirez is slick enough. You know, I think Josh is gonna be a little bit too slick and too fast.
Benavides and Charlo.
Charlo. The fuck?
You know, okay, Benavides and Plant.
Plant.
You know, Benavides and Canelo.
Canelo.
Benavides is a monster.
But Benavides is good. I don't want to sound like I'm against Benavides, but okay, with Charlo, I'm with my nigga. Of course. With Caleb, again, I'm with my wigga. With Canelo, I mean, he's fighting Canelo. I mean, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just being honest.
Devin Haney was calling you out. What do you think about you and Haney? Is that a fight?
I mean, at this point, I don't need no Devin Haney. You know, I get what they're trying to do. You know, I commend them. You know, they trying to take the same kind of strike that I took at boxing. And they're young, you know, and they're just calling out fighters, trying to make fights. So that's good. You know, I want them to just stay focused like you're doing, stay dedicated to boxing, and you know, sky's the limit for them.
What's the best advice you ever got for boxing since you started from day one?
Only you can beat you.
What's the worst advice you ever got?
The worst?
I'll give you an example. Amir Khan had a contract with Reebok for $10 million. Someone told him, come with me into the Nike store and buy things for $10,000. He did it, and then Reebok found out and they cut him. That was bad advice that he took.
The dumbest advice I got from boxing? Honestly, I've never gotten no bad advice. I really haven't gotten no bad advice from no one in my corner.
That's good. You're lucky.
Yeah, no one.
Nah, but then again, you're always the leader of the pack.
Yeah.
So you got.
even if it's a bad choice, I made it. So I don't.
How long have you known Gerald Tucker?
Since I was a kid, man.
He's a little older, right?
Yeah.
He was boxing before you.
Yeah.
Was he in your same gym with you?
Yep.
You also from Cincinnati?
Yeah.
Cause I saw
we all grew up together.
And you guys are still around, which is very rare. Because think about it, most friends that you had at junior high or high school or middle school, they're not around anymore.
Yep. We all grew up together, man. Acting up. Everybody had the same drink.
So, Gerald, what can we expect this fight from AJ? You've been here since day one in this camp, before the camp even.
I think I'm more focused, more mature. You see the bigger picture better now. Not like you're looking past the guy, but you just see his movement, his whole movement. You know what he got to do, each fight to make the ending happen the way he wanted to happen. That's the thing. Our will.
You heard Mike Tyson is fighting Evander again for the third time, this time an exhibition.
Great, that's the Evander trainer hard too.
I'm telling you want Mike Tyson, I'm gonna start promoting it. All he has to do is wear 30 ounces.
Yeah, when you wear 30 ounces, we can hit. I ain't tripping. I go in there with my 8-ton and put on his 30s. You go out the field, ease.
You get just the hand wraps on.
You would just have hand wraps on, like bare knuckle?
Yeah. I feel more comfortable with a glove, though.
Jerald, when you go places, like the airport, which athlete did they confuse you with the most? Who do you get?
Only give one person, man. Well, it's two people. A lot of the women, they say Trey Songz, whoever that is.
The rapper.
And the OK rapper.
Right?
Yeah, that's what they say.
Okay, who's that one?
Nah, some basketball player though. Some light-skinned basketball player.
Spud Webb?
Van Fleet, something like that. I be signing autographs and shit too.
Okay, bro.
I literally do.
Right, bro.
That's what they say, man. That's what they say. I look like Trey Songz, man. Before I come up,
get out of here, bro.
I'm not allowed to push it, you not, man. And Usher sometimes. Hey, man. I don't know. I ain't make this shit up.
Cloud on some bullshit.
Right. Adrian, everyone knows it's you, but does anyone ever confuse you with another fighter or another athlete?
Nah, he just do that shit
all
playing.
The time. Oh.
Nah. He do that shit playing. He play too much. He do that shit on purpose playing, bro.
They mistake him for Birdo every couple times.
I saw that. And you look nothing like Birdo.
But man, he do that on purpose playing.
You told them Andre Birdo's here.
He be joking, bro. He play too much, man.
I saw
video. Let me scoot away a little bit, because he getting kind of close to my face. He getting mad, he getting angry. But
playing, bro.
Since the Super Bowl, now people going to be calling him Antonio Brown. I'm saying he got that once or twice before, too. But more people, since he came to him, but I'm more going to be mistaken. Antonio Brown, I never see how he get close to my face.
Oh. Adrian, is Tom Brady the greatest team sport superstar ever?
Yeah.
You agree?
Looking at Jordan and Kobe and LeBron, I don't know.
Yeah.
Quarterback is different sports. Like football, the quarterback is the focus. Like he got the ball every time. Now basketball, it's five guys that gotta keep sharing the ball. I'm saying he get touched the ball every single time. You know what I'm saying? So I see it different. I say keep football. And keep basketball. We try to compare it to.
Hey, bro, Tom Brady is dope, bro.
He's true. And football, he's dope.
How old is he?
Oh,
no.
42?
He's dope, bro.
And football.
What do you think of Canelo and Charlo? Do you like that fight?
Not right now.
I don't think they should fight right now either.
But I'm rocking with the Charlo.
I want Charlo to win, so I don't want it to happen right now. I need to catch it.
And I'm saying that. I got love for them niggas, even though that, you know, I don't know what they be on sometimes, but I got love for them niggas.
You love everybody, Adrian. I've really never heard you say anything bad about anybody. Believe it or not, I've known you like 11 years. You don't hate any? Does he hate anybody?
I ain't never heard him say nothing crazy about nobody.
You have a lot of haters, but in the end, they're fans too.
I don't got no bad blood with nobody, man.
Let me tell you what Kobe Bryant said. They never hate the good ones, they hate the great ones.
Yeah.
If you're just good, they don't hate you. Listen, becoming a four division champion was so easy. How come very few do it? It's not easy.
Next. It's only a short list.
Yeah. So are you going to spar him today? At least one round?
Earlier he did some shit that made me think about it, man. But he's starting to, I'm feeling a little
what
better.
What did I do so I can do it again?
Raise your voice again. That's gonna be another one.
You ate his pickle, his kosher. What was it?
Talk like that. Sounds crazy.
That sounds crazy.
No. Okay, I'll explain.
Okay, go.
You ordered in the mail in Amazon a box. A huge box of dill pickles.
And I took four.
You took one without permission.
I took four.
You know what they do in Saudi Arabia if you steal?
They
charge your arm off.
Oh, yeah, shit.
They don't play.
Good thing we ain't there.
You made him do push-ups?
Been stealing a lot lately. Just stole the pop.
I'm ball. I can replace that. That's ball.
But
that's stealing.
But GT, you weren't running with him in the beginning every day.
Yeah, until I pulled my hamstring.
Yeah. He hurt himself.
Sprint day.
Quit.
He knew what he was doing. He took me to a real wet surface. Yeah, for real, because he knows the runs was about to get real intense. I was about to have him doing some other shit. He's going to be running marathons. So he's like, let me go ahead and stop there because I don't want to run marathons this camp. But guess what? Next camp, marathons.
So you saying I did this?
You took me to a wet surface. For real, you set it up. You had you, you strategic. You set it up.
It was by design, he's saying, that he planned it.
To a wet surface, he let me go first. Let me go first. And he's watching. It's crazy. I see it all happening. He was laughing just like that, too. He was laughing just like that.
But you're okay now, right?
Yeah, I'm good now. No, I ran my first mile last week. And, this week. And it's on the two.
So you're saying I did, this was...
How many times I got to say it? What I'm saying? Sign language, Chinese, Spanish?
So when is the reality show coming? They need to do a reality show about you. Adrien, just follow you around with the camera for like 2 weeks. Do you agree? It would be a...
It's coming soon.
If you want me to produce it, I'll do it. Just let me know. All we need to do, we'll get it on Netflix, Apple TV, Amazon.
Damn, man.
Hey, guest starring Robert Easter.
Yeah.
Do you get any new tattoos lately?
Oh yeah.
What is that?
That's
my TBT
logo,
some
boxing gloves,
and
AB about
this.
Hey,
Sean,
hey,
buddy.
This is me, look.
I can see the resemblance.
That's really cool. That's AB down there. I gotta have my brothers with me, man, all the time. Wow.
Is that the first?
Hey, show them the cheetah print you got on your ass.
It's okay. It's okay, we'll skip that one.
It's okay.
But that's really cool that he got a tattoo. Like, that shows a lot of respect. Like, yeah, he's appreciative.
Sure. You already know, man. They grow.
Has anyone seen the tattoo yet, or we're the first ones?
Yeah, people seen it.
What did they say?
It's cool. I mean, I'm loyal all the way to
Toledo, Ohio. You're looking in shape, too. Who you want to call out? He's in your card, right?
Hell yeah.
Who are you fighting, Rashid? Who are you gonna fight on this card?
Some guy from St. Louis.
St. Louis?
Some guy. That's all I'm gonna say, some guy.
It don't matter. So Gerald, you were essentially a teammate of Floyd Mayweather in the 96 Olympics.
Yeah,
what was that like?
Floyd,
Fernando Vargas, Reed,
Eric Burrell,
Zab Judah.
Yeah, we had a squad, man. No, that was like the one of the greatest Olympic boxing teams of all time, man. They came out with I think seven or eight became world champions and pros. So yeah, that was a great team. Great, and I was the youngest of everybody, so I soaked up a lot of game. I was paying attention to everything.
Are you still in touch with a lot of your teammates?
Oh yeah. You know, social media wise, I'm real private. I don't like the phone too much. I don't have the phone at all. You know, I'm all about business. But man, that's AB too. But keep it touching on social media. I love everybody though.
Yeah, no, everybody loves you. Remember, I talked with Zab, but I didn't even know you were his roommate. Did he pull any pranks? Like, did you wake up in the middle of the night with water, like all kinds?
Nah, man, Zab, he just more luckier than me, man. Every time we bring two girls back, he seemed to be the only one lucky, man. So, but that was 96. I was 17, a fresh 17-year-old. He had a little more age over me, so yeah, he was just luckier. He had a better mouthpiece. He had that New York gift of gab, man, that Brooklyn shit.
Yeah. And it worked.
I like the accent.
Yeah. Zab's a great dude. I'm glad he's doing great.
Yeah, hell yeah, man. Yeah, Zab's the truth, man. Zab, super positive, man. He love everybody. Everybody love him, man. And yeah, I love it.
Okay, if Adrien Broner had to go to the Olympics in a different sport besides boxing, what do you think he'd be great at?
They say swimming.
No, I'll tell you what. No, it could be because every team, every country that holds the Olympics can have their own sport. So I think the U.S. next time it's here should do shooting dice as a sport. If walking is a sport and bridge is a sport.
Yeah, it used to, when we were younger, we had to go to like little small tournaments. And he'd say he was about 7, 8 years old. The police would be out front in the lobby, man. Like the lights blaze in the parking lot. And it's because he.
Getting us kicked out of the hotel, man.
Dice at age 7, man. He's a professional dice shooter.
Yeah?
Yeah.
But y'all be people when I be people.
Oh, I saw, speaking of which, what's his name? Rich. He came to visit.
Oh, you mean Rick Ross?
Rick Ross was here, and Rashad Evans was here.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of stars have come to support you.
Yeah, a lot of.
Of course.
Yeah. coming, man.
I'm waiting for Adrien to do for me a new intro song for ES News. Adrien, I need like 6 seconds of something ES News. I need to update the intro.
He's gonna do it right too. It's the intro, man. Everybody keep hitting me up, man. Get him to do an intro for me. Get him to do it.
Y'all greasy to the motherfucker, boy.
Are you ready, bro? America's Next Top Nigga Props.
We got cameras in here. Maybe we'll get it short.